Some strangers in the studio after being gone for a while. Midday Chalk back in the 1010 XL studios on Hogan Road. Just coming off another players weekend. And gentlemen, and I'll start with Rick first. Your overall thoughts? A champion that I don't think many people thought was going to be presented the trophy this weekend, and Siwoo Kim winning the players. But your thoughts on what you saw this weekend?
Well, he was unflappable. I mean, no pressure for such a young man, and obviously there had to have been pressure, but he didn't show it. I don't think much of anyone at all would have predicted that he would go out and win the players. But, you know, I think he had the advantage of kind of doing what he needed to do on Thursday, Friday, and Saturday without, you know, the galleries expanding or anything on those lines. But when that happened on Sunday, regardless of being challenged by some other more recognizable golfers, this man did more than just grind. He did not make any mistakes. It's almost like he'd been around the Players Championship 10, 12, 14 times, understanding some of the nuances in it. And, you know, he took what the course gave him. He made shot after shot. He becomes the youngest ever win the Players. I never saw it coming. I don't know anyone who did see it coming. But to me, what stuck out more than anything is just how cool he was under pressure.
All right. Joe C., same question to you about this weekend's Players and what you saw.
The guy's impressive. Siwoo Kim this year has had a really below average year. He's been battling back problems. The only top 10 he had during this season was all the way back in November, and that was in Malaysia. So he's given you no indication that he had the game to come in here, beat the strongest field in golf on one of the most difficult golf courses. It blows my mind that he was able to do it. 21 years of age, something we haven't seen in a long, long time. He's talented, but there are a few other South Koreans that have won once and never to be heard from again. So I hope this cat can stick around because he does have the game. But more than anything else, the golf course won. It was beautiful. It was tough. The new greens are going to soften next year. It's going to be a little more gettable. But this time around, all the guys that said, okay, this putt's going to break a little left and, you know, this is the speed for it, they were fooled. They were completely fooled. Adam Scott, Sergio Garcia, Phil Mickelson, you can go on, because a lot of the big names backed up. Golf course won this week, but hopefully those guys will be back next year ready to rock.
All right, and we'll get T-Wig's thoughts here real quick before we go. And T-Wig, your thoughts on what you saw?
I just love the names that were on the list. They were names that you don't normally see at the top of the list. With the bigger guys not playing as well, the first couple of days you had a chance to see some older players, Vijay Singh, Louis Oosthuizen. They were up at the top, and that was fun. Even Steve Stricker made a little bit of a run early. But then you got some fresh blood and some different guys that won on Sunday. So I love the fact that, you know, it might be a sign of things to come. David Lamine even said it. This kid isn't a fluke. You know, he's going to be around for a while. So maybe this is a start of something new with a new fresh name.
All right. There you have it. Rick Ballew, Joe C., and T-Wig. They have the Midday Chalk for you every day. Noon to 3 on 1010XL 92.5 FM, home of the Jacksonville Jaguars.